Yeah. Yo, what's up, guys? My name is Spike Man Dan. Welcome to my channel. If y'all like what you see, hit that subscribe button and don't forget to like. So, anyways, today we fire up the Hemi 212 with stage 3 modifications. And we also do a video shot and a GoPro run of the Hemi 212. Stick around for that. Oh yeah, I bet y'all wasn't expecting this, but yeah. Oh yeah. Oh, it feels so nice to just scratch and breathe and smoke. Mm-hmm. Oh yes. Oh, I love the smoke. So, you're all probably like, all right, come on, Spike, get the fuck to the point. Yes, you're right. Let me flip the camera. Hold up. Oh, yeah, what's up? Got the dyno cam, got the fucking engine put back together. Got the aftermarket carburetor. And guess what? It's a Hemi. I gotta put on the air breather though. Like a dumbass. I rode around without the fucking air breather, so yeah. Yeah. It's all back together. Oh, I suppose you guys wanna see it run too, huh? Oh, I guess. All right. Come on. Quit your crying. I'll start it just for you wah-wah faces. Ah. Hold on a sec. Whoa. I'm so surprised I didn't break the screen door. Huh? Whoops. Oh, that sucks. Nobody got to see that. That would have been just hilarious. Too bad I got to edit that out. So, I got it back up and running. Yo, what's up? So we're recording with the GoPro right now, and we got the new helmet with the GoPro mount. So we're gonna mount it up and take you guys for a little test run on the new Hemi Predator. Stage 3, mind you. I just don't have the valve spring switched out, and it seems to be doing it a really good deal. So I like what it's doing. It's not making the engine blow or anything, so let's go for a test ride, shall we? By the way, you guys are mounted up to the new Spike Man Death Skull. Da-da-da. Da-da-da. Yeah. So let's go for a ride, knuckles. God dang, Big Bang Theory.
Compleated.
Thank you.
Alright, so complete breakdown and review of that ride. Sorry, look like a floating head on camera. Alright, so complete review and breakdown of that ride. It's an absolute hoot. It's a blast. I don't care what anybody says, because unless you've actually had the experience to ride on a mini bike with no governor, stage 3 parts, and it's a 212, and it's a Hemi. Oh my God, you have no idea what you're missing on a mini bike. So, what I'd also like to say is, yes, I did actually, in fact, get pulled over this same night. But the officer, I'm gonna be straight up with you. The officer that pulled me over, he straight up said, "Do you know why I pulled you over?" And I flat out said, as I was taking my helmet off, "Because I'm riding in the street with a mini bike." And he's like, "You're absolutely right." So he let me go with not even a freaking printed out warning or anything like that. He just said, "Dude, do you have any headlights or taillights?" I'm like, "Absolutely. I make YouTube videos on this stuff. Don't think I don't have headlights or taillights, because I do. Spike Man comes correct." But with that being said, to one of my subscribers, "My back hurts." Yeah, that's it. That's your name. To one of my subscribers, "My back hurts." You remember the last time in the before videos, when I had my other Stage 3 212, the non-Hemi, and I blew it up, but it was also, I had videos of it, I'd rev it, and it would just fall on its face and die. You remember that? Yeah. Well, it turns out I figured out the problem. I got the carburetor. Mm-hmm. What I did is I took the sleeve out, and I readjusted the needle to where it gets more fuel on idle. So basically what that's saying is, ever since I readjusted the needle, and I'm going to have to obviously make a freaking video for that, showing you guys how to get rid of that dead spot when you guys go to accelerate it right off of the start. I got rid of that dead spot, dude. It literally fixed the entire world with the way this thing runs. Oh my God, status. It is literally like I could just rev it right off of the frickin' start of a dead stop, and it will not fall on its face. It just goes. Oh my God, it just hauls ass, dude. But yeah, I figured out the problem, and it had nothing to do with the timing. And I simply watch a shit ton of mini bike videos. So if you guys like what you see, don't forget to hit that like button and stay subscribed somewhere down there. Like, you know, it says subscribe. But please, if you guys would just subscribe and give me that watch time, because you know my videos are worth watching, especially if I'm sending shout outs to my subscribers on certain tips and tricks on how to whip out your freaking mini bike, you know? Like, I thank you guys for watching, because if it wasn't for you guys watching, I would not have so many anonymous tips or receive information about how, what's the next step I could do to this mini bike, or what do you guys want to see me do next, or, you know, like, all that stuff. So, Spike Man is out. Sorry to leave you guys on such a short note, but yeah, this is where I leave you. And you all have a wonderful evening and have an excellent freaking mini bike time. I got stuff to do. I got a whole bunch of editing to do. You know how it goes. Creators are hard workers. And then I salute every single one of you out there who's also doing the same thing. Thank you so much from the bottom of my heart. I'm Spike Man Dan, a.k.a. the Mini Bike Guy. So, yeah, until the next episode, stick around.